Hello there, my name is Mr. Smart Donkey. Welcome back to the second season, episode 9 of our Shogun 2 campaign, playing the Otomo and Shimazu. Of course, Ptolemy is with me.
Hey there.
Otherwise, this wouldn't be much of a co-op campaign. So, stuff that happened last time. I think I took a few more provinces. Actually, no, wasn't it? I think I may have taken Iwami, but the rest of that was all boring fights, where you were trying to get your general killed.
Yes.
And, yeah, and
general.
I was cleaning up the mess, and then they were just standing on the other side of the world, not wanting to fight me anymore, and it was all odd and weird.
Yes, exactly.
But now, it's not odd and weird anymore, since we are continuing on, and we're about to get rid of the Amako. It was the beginning of my turn, and I actually figured out after last time that it's going to take a long time for these two European cannons to get anywhere. So I figure I'm going to use my two trade ships here in next turn when they are repaired. I don't have any enemies except for the Amako, so I should be able to safely get them across there. And I'm just going to drop them off right in Amako territory, because by that time I should have taken control of it already. I could actually get there this turn, which is tempting.
That's if the Chosokabe don't take it.
Yeah, well, that's why I need to get there as fast as possible, I guess. So, Suo is 4 happiness, which is important because if I want to take it, I need to get some of my men from Suo over to Aki or Iwami, depending on where I'm going to have my main army. So I'm going to try and take it right now, actually, because I think besides that, I can't really do a whole lot. So I'm taking my whole army, going to make him run. Oh, yeah. This is, oh wow, those forces are, oh, that's just Chosokabe, actually, yeah.
Yeah.
So they are actually joining me.
Are they?
But, yeah, but
they, they're close enough, are they?
Yeah, but they're not getting it, so too bad for you, Chosokabe. Lost 2 men, completely fine, and, well, didn't get any experience, but whatever. Alright, so that is the Yamako done.
Yeah, look what the Chosokabe got back, pushed back to. they dropped in by ship, and then they got pushed like 1,000 miles across.
Yeah, they're freaking miles away, aren't they? Yeah. Right, so I'm gonna repair this. There's actually a Yari drill yard here, which isn't very useful. Right, so this was what we were wondering last time. I've got the Pilgrim Hostel here, which gives me +1 experience for all Bow Warrior Monk recruits, +3 morale for all land units recruited in this province, and +1 experience for all Naginata Warrior Monk. So yeah, I don't think I can actually make warrior monks anymore regardless, but the +3 morale for all land units recruited. I don't think I'm ever going to recruit anything here, but still, that's alright.
Yeah, it's nice to know that if you did decide to build anything there, you could get extra experience for them.
Yeah.
It's a shame that it doesn't apply to agents, though.
Yeah, monks, like actual monks, that'd be useful.
Yeah.
Oh well. Right. It's, wow, I lost 2 men, by the way, and they were both my son and heir men. That's interesting. Right, so I'm going to send over 4 of the units from Suo, including my general, I reckon. Yeah, he's not doing anything useful in that town. So I'm going to send him over with the imported Matsukashigara, because they're actually going to be useful. These guys, because they have decent experience. Actually, I'll send these guys, yeah. Right, I'm going to send them over to Aki. And then through Aki, I'll go towards Iwami, I think, and I'll probably put them there, or I may leave them in Aki and then take my army towards Iwami again, because Iwami is currently unhappy, but they should be alright until next turn.
Yeah, they're not happy.
No, yeah, but it's alright. Now it's just a question of who we are going to attack next. Obviously, we need to get rid of the Chosokabe at some point anyway, so that might be a good choice to get, or try and get rid of them, because I really don't want to stop my trade with the Takaoko yet, because I'm making tons of money from them.
Well, if you can give me, like, let's see, 2 turns for that, and then I'll need, how many can I recruit each turn? 4 per turn. So if you give me, like, 12 turns, I'll be ready to invade the Chosokabe with my badass samurais.
Alright, that sounds good. I might attack him regardless, and I'm not pull you in yet, and just to take down their bingo, because I want to get bingo as well.
Yeah, you can do that.
And then
I totally call their island though.
I was gonna say I might send over some units to start beating down their island, but we'll see what we do with that. Right now,
if you go fight them for sure, that's not a problem. Yeah. I just call the towns. That's all.
Like, you don't
have provinces right now.
If you look on the map right now, it's actually pretty funny the way the my color and the Takaoko match up. It's a pretty damn similar color.
It actually lines up with Bingo is where the border is with Takaoka, but. The colour's so similar.
Yeah, that's so similar. It's ridiculous. Right, so clan destroyed Amako, province captured Aki. I have some money left, but I don't think I was actually doing anything or was able to do anything with the money. Because I'm still working on equal fields, which will be done next turn, and then I'm going to start making a bunch of units. A bunch of farms all around the world. So I have some ships over here, which I think I might actually send... I'm gonna leave the trade ships, because they're a wacko pirate trade ship. I don't care about them, they can just sit there. And I'm gonna take these two ships, and I'm actually gonna probably use these two ships instead to pick up my European cannons, because they're more formidable, and be safer to do that.
Ah, the Waco Boons, or Boonays.
Indeed. Another thing that we noticed, we can actually see the Date now, no idea why, because we couldn't see them at the end of the last set, but... we'll take it. I can actually trade with them, see if they actually want to do that. Probably not. They do. Awesome. They actually have two enemies, which are the Honma and the Hatakeyama, which is pretty funny, because in my single-player campaign, those are the two clans that are actually my vassals as the Date. So that's pretty coincidental.
They're getting some payback.
Indeed. I think that's it. Aki, I'm already making stuff that I want to make. Same here. I'll end my turn. Let you do what you do. Before you
I have to say, those Ikko are looking incredibly scary.
Yeah, they are pretty formidable, it seems. So, I just saw some boats from the Yasuji flying around, and I believe I'm still at war with them, so...
Aye?
Yeah, because they want. Yeah, they offered me a peace treaty if I broke my trade agreement and gave them $1,800.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, and I was like, nah, I think I won't.
Yeah, they're not exactly scary.
No, I forgot to move my agents, I believe, or at least the Matsuke. Oh well.
Yeah, Sasake are getting. They got another province.
Oh damn. I'm not at war with them anymore, though.
No.
Or never was, but. I was thinking of going... Oh, here we go. The Takaoka declared war on me, so I know who we're going to be fighting.
Oh, well, there you go, then. You've got your...
Yeah. Do you want to join?
I can do, if you like.
Sure. Hopefully they don't come straight away, because I need one more turn to pull back my army north so I can actually defend. And they've got ships that might be attacking me. They've got...
They have to be a peace treaty immediately.
I've got tons of ships as well, so I actually might need my naval or navy.
Apparently their power is strong.
Yeah, they've got 10 provinces, don't they?
Yeah, they're treacherous for integrity as well.
Well, yeah, we just found that out.
They're just spoiling for a fight, that's all.
That's a bit of a downside of Shogun, or I don't know, it might be more Total War games as well. Just like whenever you border someone, immediately they're like, oh, you're bordering me, so we're going to war. It's not like...
Not immediately, but often. Fairly often, yeah. Yeah.
Get
these
off it.
Fucking pirates.
Yeah. God damn it.
Marco destroyed. We knew that. So, I have 28 grand right now.
That is pretty good money.
Yes, it is. Alright. Osumi is finally happy. It has some repression left, but we're getting there. We are definitely getting there. My construction takes another turn. I'm going to build a warhorse stables in Satsuma, which is going to take 3 turns. And I have some katana samurai here that I don't really want, because they've only got silver upgraded armor. That's best I can make right now, but in one more turn I'll be able to make better stuff, so I don't really want them. Apparently I've got more trade ships here. That's to fix up that trade fleet down there. But I can't do that right now. Maybe I should start making some kind of fleet. I could just make a Namban trade ship and just blow them out of the water with it.
Yeah, you could do.
I'm going to do that.
You've got plenty of money anyway, don't you?
Yeah. I mean, they cost a lot to upkeep, but if I have one on each trade route, then they're not going to be able to mess with me, really, are they?
No.
So, yeah, I think I'll do that. I'll have one for each trade route, and that probably will cancel out a lot of the money that I'll be making from it, but, yeah, at least it'll be paying for itself.
Indeed.
Everything else is pretty much done, I think. Yep, everything else is done. I have another turn till Essence of Spirit is done. I'm not quite sure why I'm doing that. Minus 20% for missionary actions and enables me to build a mission, but I don't really care about a mission. Tea ceremony would be nice. It would gain Daimyo's honor, but frankly, I don't really need any of that. I don't even really need Chunindo right now, because I've got plenty of food. I don't really need the lacquerware shops or land consolidation or the bow maker. So, I'm not really bothered about that. I'm half tempted just to switch to Way of the Sword and go down to Kenjutsu Mastery.
I would do that as fast as I could if I were you.
Well, it's going to take... it says 43 turns, but I don't know if that's including everything else or not. I don't think it is.
Yeah. Where did you click on? Did you click on Kenjutsu Mastery?
Oh, yeah, I did. Yeah, so then it's 43 turns to get there.
Yeah, it takes everything into consideration.
Yeah. All right. Well, actually, I'm going to do Essence of Spirit first because I only got one turn left on it. But once that's done, I'll go into Kenjutsu Mastery. And ending turn because I have nothing interesting to do because I'm boring like that.
Yay. Right, my trade agreement broke with the Takaoka, which makes sense. Mounting across the Umami, already knew that. Trade routes raided twice, and we're making tax reform because we finished up equal fields. We discovered a concealed army, which is interesting. Can we actually bribe that? We could. Ooh. Can we see any of that? No, we can't. It only costs 700 bucks for 83% chance. That might be worth it, just for fun.
What army where?
This two-unit army, which is hidden right there.
Oh yeah, because you've got Matsuki all the way
right
there.
Yeah, that's why you discovered them as well. Anyway, let's do important things first. I am making improved irrigation in like four towns now. Now I need another turn so I can get the rest of the money for all my other towns.
I can give you money.
I guess, but it's not really a rush, so it should be fine.
Yeah.
Let's see, I'm going to take my army from Aki and send them up into Iwami again. And then Aki's going to be unhappy, but I've got these few units that are going to go in there. Still going to be unhappy, but only minus four, so I can exempt them from taxes later if I have to.
Which you probably will have to.
Yeah, unless I make some units and maybe send some other stuff over, but meh, not too bothered. Let's see, so... I have some money. Let's bribe these units. There's only two, and if I can get both of them, I might be able to take a town there. Oh, I failed on 83% chance. What is up with my agents? It's unbelievable how shit they are.
It's the same for my agents.
True.
That's why I don't use them.
Right, I can nearly take up my missionary here, which would be good, because I need him in other places. I do have a missionary somewhere else, I believe, yeah. Apparently didn't move last turn, even though he's got like a setup thing to start moving. But regardless, so now I'm a bit worried. Should I take on my two European cannons? I think I'll just run them because now it's a little bit more risky since there's so many Takaoka boats around that I don't really want to risk that at all.
Yeah, it's probably the right call.
So I'll run them over. It's going to take forever, but whatever.
Question is, do you really want them?
The cannons?
Yeah.
Why not?
Well, because they're stupidly slow. But they have a range, amazing range, but...
I want them, yeah.
Okay.
I mean, even just for auto-resolving, it's like it's going to put up my meter so much because it's like siege equipment.
Can you upgrade your Fletchers anymore yet?
No, I need another point in... I need Chunindo, which I'm going for later on at some point, maybe. Right, so my navy is shy one ship, so it's got 9 ships, but it should be able to withstand most stuff, at least for now. I'm going to put these two guys in here in case I lose some trade ships. I've got a few to back up with, and I've got 2 over here as well, but I won't send them anywhere for now because that's too dangerous. Let's see, any diplomacy? Since I lost the trade agreement, I can get one going with the Satake if they accept it, which they do.
They've also just lost their province that they just took as well.
Ooh, to the Satomi. That is interesting, because they were allied to the Satomi before.
Seems like the marriage made in heaven was not quite as good as they thought it was.
Indeed. Let's see the Ikoiki. They're at war with only the Anaga Koji right now. So the Anaga Koji are probably going to lose their last province right here.
Oh yeah, that's definitely.
Pretty damn soon. And after that, we're going to have to see what they decide to do. There's not a whole lot I can do now, though.
Fortunately, we don't have to deal with them just yet.
That is true.
Although we will be soon.
I'm going to start moving up my ninja. Probably going to have him in the army. And I possibly might put that monk in the army as well, because then as it goes along, it will just recover or make happiness stuff for Christianity. Yeah. There you go.
Make stuff happen.
Yay. Stuff happening. Right, so I think I made a few buildings as well. I made the powder maker, right. I don't think I can upgrade that yet, but that does mean I can actually get my Dunderbuss Cavalry.
Ooh.
And I can also get fire projecting mongrels. Let's have a quick look at the fire projecting mongrels compared to the European cannons. They seem to be... They've got a slightly higher reload skill, but their accuracy is a lot lower. And their range is slightly lower. So yeah, it's basically just a shittier... I guess it's a good if you can't go... If you're not going for... what do you call it? If you're not going for... that stuff.
If you're not Christian,
there you go. And I can also make my Portuguese tercos. Let's have a look. I believe I can make more of them than one. I just can't because I don't have the money right now, but I can make more of them. So I think I might actually start making some Dunderbuss cavalry. I want to have 2 of those units and probably, well, as many Portuguese tercos as I can get. Because if I can just replace my matchlocks with Portuguese tercos, that works.
That does sound good, yeah.
Depends on how many men they get, though. Their reload skill is 35 over 15, so yeah, that's going to be a very big difference right there. Yeah. Their accuracy is 75 over 45. Wow, I cannot wait to start using those guys. I'm going to cancel my recruitment, actually, since I need to wait for them to all to get done anyway. Yeah, I'm going to end my turn.
Okay.
Do stuff. Oh, they're attacking me. They're attacking the port. All right.
Oh well.
Yeah, that's 3,000 per turn right there.
But they just cut off.
Yeah. Ooh. So I need to actually get my ships over there. Oh, war declared on by the Chisicabe.
Oh, lovely.
That's not so good because they're right next to me and I just put my army up north. I guess I'll pull you in.
Yeah, if you like.
And they're allies on the Miyoshi, but they probably won't join.
Yeah, screw the Miyoshi.
Yeah, they didn't. Alright, let's see if they attack straight. Oh, okay, I guess they do. Opportunity to intercept. Wait, what?
Yeah, you don't want to take that.
Oh, right, yeah. No, I don't think I do.
Well, you definitely don't. You won't be able to beat it.
Yeah, I reckon... I reckon we might have a shot of winning... yeah, I'll decline that. If they siege me here, I reckon we have a shot of winning it. Because we have one gunman troop, and if we can just use the cavalry unit, there's a lot of bowmen, that's going to be the only issue.
Yeah, I don't see you winning that at all, in any universe.
Oh. let's prove you wrong, then.
Yeah.
I reckon it's got a pretty good shot at winning that.
Not with 4 bow samurai, no.
I don't know. I think they're going to be annoying, but because I've got the defensive position, they won't be able to do a lot of damage.
What I want to know is, how come they could land and attack the same turn? Because every time I land, I can't
move
anywhere.
Yeah, it's fucking stupid. I don't know how that works. Even when your ship's like right next to where it is, you land them and then they can't move anymore. Or the other way around, when your ship's right next to the people that want to get on the ships, on the navy, they board the ships and then you can't move anymore. It's like they move like 20 feet. What the hell?
So, yeah, what the fuck was that about?
It took an entire season to get on some ships. Are you joking? Alright. I think they're gonna come majority from there. And maybe a few units from the other side. Possibly some bowmen. So let's put these men like so. And the rest. I'm actually gonna give you my general.
Oh, no pressure then.
No, of course not. He's the guy that just was fit for command, so.
Oh, okay. So if he does die, it's not a huge issue.
No, it's not the biggest issue, no. But yeah, just do use the same tactic as before. Plant him outside, I guess.
Where should I deploy him to start with?
I'd say there, around there anyway.
Alright.
I reckon that's where the biggest force is going to come from, including the general. Alright. Oh wow, this split up into four things. That's some bow samurai. That is Yari.
Two bow samurai coming towards the general. Two bows and Yari.
Yeah, I'm gonna put them where those three Yari units are. Mostly.
I was gonna go and try and kite those four over there.
Yeah, that works too, but.
I definitely can't kite the archers, so you know.
Yeah, that's.
Or at least not very effectively, anyway.
Oh yeah, they're just a cavalry bow samurai as well, so. You're already getting charged then, look at that. My men are nearly on the wall. By the time they get on the wall, they should be able to shoot right off the bat as well.
Well, I'm not in a rush to run away. So they can charge me if they like.
Indeed. Alright, that was perfect timing for getting on the wall, because that unit right there is going to get shot instantly. Boom, boom, pew, pew.
That was pretty nice volley right there.
Yeah, and it's not even half done yet. Yeah, and they've got a few men on purpose on the left as well of the wall, so once you run those guys around here, they get shot as well. Ooh, I did lose quite a few units from that archer attacking.
Well, this is going to be interesting. Oh, they're wavering already.
Lol.
Yeah, those archers are shooting you.
Yeah, I'm thinking of pulling out all my men and just distracting the archers.
You could possibly do that.
I'll leave this unit in here. And yeah, just so I can keep him busy, I guess.
Our general is in grave danger, my lord!
Yeah, that was dumb. I was trying to get through the middle and got like one guy caught.
Oh no.
Yeah, annoyingly, that means getting close to their archers that way. Let's back off, shall we?
Yeah, I don't think this is gonna win, but hey.
Yeah, I'm giving it a shot. It would. Well, you can only try.
Indeed.
Circling around these guys. I mean, if you can kill off those bow samurai, then you might have a chance, but I won't be able to kill them.
I'm just trying to distract them, really. I'm getting charged in the back now as well by a Yari Ishigaru unit.
Yeah, I'll try and get over and help, but you're probably going to break before I get there.
Yeah, because I think my Yari Ishigaru won't even win a melee fight against one unit of Shishikabe bow samurai.
Our men are running from the battlefield.
Oh, I was trying to get over and inspire them, but. Could not do it. They're too far away.
It's alright. I assume you don't have the option to retreat the general?
Nope.
That was a not very long-lasting duty then.
No. Oops, shit. Getting shot in the back there. On the plus side, at least you've done a fair bit of damage.
That is true.
A lot more damage than if you'd auto-resolved it.
Yeah, that is true.
Oh, well, you killed nearly half of that Chose Kali Bow Samurai unit.
Not bad. I got half my matchlock unit left, but we're about to get... They're about to climb the walls.
I'm gonna charge them the second they go out of the walls. Just because that should be really effective, because I shouldn't be able to protect behind them while they're climbing. Might take some damage from the archers, but... I reckon it's totally worth it. There's a broken Ashigara unit there. Here we go, this is going to be interesting. Decent amount of damage.
That's good. Yeah, I actually got some archers in range now, so I'm starting to shoot their archers with my gunman.
That is good. Just gonna continue kiting now. He's pretty tired now.
I'm not sure how this Yari Ashigaro unit's doing so well against my samurai retainers, but.
Don't know, but half the unit's dead. So that's a good thing.
All those units are just like all over the place that are chasing you.
Yeah. So I've just been going round and round in circles. Look at that. Oh, not quite. They're wavering still.
Yeah, I'm not killing any of them, it feels like.
Oh, you're killing them.
Not very fast though. I mean, they're tired as well. I've got some retainers. It seems like I'm dying faster than they are. Oh, they're broken. Something.
Oh, good. Damn it, those archers. Fucking. What are you doing turning around?
Our men are running from the battlefield. Shameful display.
Oh, is that you?
Yeah, general routed.
Oh well.
He might recover, he's still on my my tag thing at the bottom.
Yeah, he's broken, not shattered, I guess.
I don't think he will recover, but he could. It's a possibility. Oh, but yeah, those Samurai 10 are fucked up. Yeah.
Yeah, everyone's dead.
Yeah, there's
no way.
Definitely
messed them up there.
He's come back, and now he's run again. He stopped routing for just a nanosecond, and then he shattered.
Got three samurai retainers left. Yeah. Three. Much luck. Let's see who dies first. Come on, shoot. You got two men left. Shoot.
Our entire
dead.
Unit has perished, my lord.
All right, one more samurai retainer. He's dead.
Well, you did quite a lot of damage.
Yeah. Still annoying though. Finally got a general. He gets killed the first fucking first fight he gets into.
Yeah, that kind of sucks.
Close defeat, yeah, I guess.
I suppose.
Yeah, too many archers.
I think it should have been an inevitable defeat.
Yeah.
Inevitable. That's a dodgy word, and I can very rarely say it properly.
Inevitable?
Yeah.
Alright. So yeah, I lost one town. I think I was making a shit ton of stuff in this town as well. And now I'm being attacked by
possibly
from two sides, which is a bit annoying.
Yes, I'm still going to need a few turns to build up my army before I can come and help.
See, now you have the money, but not the manpower.
I need six turns and I'll have 12 units of samurai.
Killed 559 of them, we lost 441.
That's pretty impressive.
Indeed. Oh, if only I had like one more gunman unit or something. That would have been such a different story. Oh god, what's that? Oh, Jesus.
They're offering me peace. No, I don't think so. Apparently their prosperity is moderate.
This is going to be dangerous.
Yes.
I need them to come and attack me. Oh, yeah, they took out the Anagakoji.
Yes, they did. Actually, no, they didn't. The Isuji did.
Oh, yeah, you're right. That is interesting.
It is. Wouldn't surprise me if the Ikko take them out soon.
Oh, come on. Now I'm being attacked from two sides, and I've only got one army.
Where were they?
Right next to the town where my massive army is in. But if the Tsuchikage decide to go west instead of north, they can just take out whatever they want.
Might not be a bad idea to start building a second army then.
Yeah, true, but I guess I am sort of, because I'm about to start making all those good units. Yeah. I'm not making a lot of money because someone interrupted my damn trade for 3,000 stupid Tsuchikage Navy.
Yeah, it's annoying that they can stop your trade from half the world away and there's basically nothing you can do about it.
Yeah. Hopefully I can get my navy over there. Can't see it yet.
Possibly. Oh, clan destroyed. Yeah, I see. And I those guys.
Indeed.
Yeah. And I've got fucking Waco pirates still sitting on my fucking trade ports. Or trade routes, rather. Right, so my jujitsu dojo is done. So, I can now get samurai with superior armor and improved melee. Which is not exactly as great as I was hoping it was going to be, frankly.
I lost like 3,000 bucks, by the way, because I was making a trading or upgrading the trading port and the roads. And I think even the improved irrigation as well.
Ouch.
So that's like 5,000 bucks that... And they're not even making it anymore, so... That's annoying. Yeah.
I could donate you a couple of katana samurai if you want them.
No, I'm good. For now, anyway.
I can use them as well, but... I'm going to send them north for now. To Higo. And Satsuma's happy, isn't it? Yes, everything is good there. That is excellent. My daimyo is not going to join the army. He's not going to be leading it. His brother will be leading it, I think. Actually, no. Hold on. Can I set my heir again? Surely that other guy has come of age now. His brother. Oh, okay. Apparently, no, he hasn't. He's 21 and he still hasn't come of age. Is he retarded or something?
Lazy bastard. If I were you, I would put your daimyo in the main army, because otherwise, if other people are gonna like get more experience than him, then they're gonna get the delusion of grandeur and lose loyalty because of it.
Yeah, he's actually only got 2 loyalty. That sucks, because my other guy has like 5. He has 4. And my daimyo has 2. That sucks. Oh well. He's gonna lead the army anyway.
On the daimyo.
Yeah, to honor, yeah.
Right.
That's really fucking bad. But oh well. So I'm now recruiting 6 samurai. It's gonna take 4 turns. And oh, I've got a whole bunch more fucking Yariashigari here as well. I've got one of them with improved armor. Don't know how they managed to get that. Right, oh, I can improve to a mission as well. I'll do that. In Hugo, there's nothing I can do. And Higo, I can upgrade to a rice exchange. Yeah, I'll do that. I've got plenty of food spare, so I can do that. I can only build a light cab there as well, which kind of sucks, but never mind. Apparently, I can also get another Matsuki. Yeah, go on then, I'll have one. Why not? And what else is there to do? I'm just going to quickly check diplomacy. I could trade with the Date, apparently. I don't think I'll actually get anything out of it, because I'm pretty sure that my trade route will be interrupted, but I may as well give it a go.
Rudely interrupted.
Yes, very rudely interrupted. So, how many provinces do you have? 19. It's ridiculous. Ridiculous. Their power is terrifying, apparently. It is, yes.
Yeah, that's pretty terrifying.
Yeah. And everything else is done. Let's end turn.
Alright, I basically just did everything already, so... Oh, like, God, my entire screen full. Province lost. Invasion force lands. Army crushed. Port blockaded. Sea trade raided. Sea trade raided, 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 raided. Okay, construction report. Made my stronghold and my castle. Can't destroy the Anagakoji, an honorable death, Ogata Tadaoki, my general, and apparently a path has been blocked. Yeah, I need to get these ships over here. Oh, that's just good. I can get right there and be in range for reinforcements, so get the hell out of here. Thank you. Alright, so that gave me back all my money that I was losing from trade. Repair those, and that leaves me with not a lot of money. You guys need to go over to... I'm actually going to send these over to Nagato, because it's safer than going to Seoul in case the Chozokabe decide to go west right now.
Yeah, because that would be bad.
Indeed. This missionary, also to Nagato, and I'll send him into the main army soon. Can I see any of this reinforcing army? No. I can see that it has a lot of units, but I can't see what's in it. I think it's basically... yeah, about an army and maybe five more extra units as well. But if I'm at a defending position, I should easily be able to defeat it, and maybe even an attacking position.
I wouldn't like to attack it, but yeah, you could probably defend it.
Yeah. So yeah, I'm waiting for the Takako to attack first, and then I'll clean them up and go south towards the Chozokabe stuff, because I really don't want to attack the Chozokabe and let them take Iwami and then lose a ton of stuff on the Chozokabe. I'd rather the Chozokabe go west. They're only going to get there. It's going to take at least two turns for them to get the Suo. So I'll take Aki before they even get the Suo, and then they're going to have to take Aki while I'm defending with an entire massive awesome army. So that should be fine.
Yep.
You guys, what the... Can you see? I don't think you can see that. This navy is like blinking as if it's like an enemy navy. Oh no, I'm blockading the trade. Or
yeah.
Oh
yeah.
Right, that's okay.
That's what happens when you blockade, it flashes.
Yeah. I didn't mean to blockade, I just meant to get into range, but I guess this works. I didn't mean to I don't mean to piss anyone off who likes me, but
unless you're at war with them it won't do anything.
Yeah, I guess.
And it doesn't use up any movement points either, so.
Alright.
There's no reason not to do it, frankly.
I think I'm intercepting some money because of it as well.
Probably.
Alright. Let's see. It doesn't look like the Takaoka armies or navies are going towards my trade ships, so that's good. Yeah, I spent all my money. I have a Matsuke who could be moving around a little bit. He's just sitting there uselessly. So let's have him move towards these towns so I can see if there's anything in there. I can see Bingo as well. I assume there's nothing left there, but... Can have a look. And a missionary. I've got two of them here. I can actually move one of them out now. My bigger one. And I'll put him in my army. Which will increase happiness and decrease actions before me. Okay, so that's not going to help me because it's not an army. It's because it's going into the town. Whatever.
Well, you know, it helps in a roundabout way.
Yeah, indeed. Yeah, I'm leaving my other agent there. He can't even move because I already did that. I moved you guys. You guys are just going to sit there and wait for your inevitable death. My ninja. Nah, it's not high enough chance to sabotage the armies. No, I'm not going to bother with that.
You could try and assassinate that 4-star general up there.
Well, with my 1-star ninja.
Well, you know. What else are you going to do?
Well, not get him killed. At least try. Alright, here's the Chozokabe.
It's a bunch of ships.
Yeah, that one navy I can deal with, I think. I should probably make one of those ships as well, like you do, just to have it, like, it's gonna make such a big difference as well.
It will, yeah.
Ooh, they didn't attack me, or I don't think they even moved towards me, so that's good. If the Takaoko attacked me, that would be amazing.
That would be very good, yes.
Yeah.
That would be exactly what we want them to do.
But of course, because that's what we want them to do, they won't do it.
Oh no, of course they won't.
I mean...
They'll just sit there threatening you until you make a move.
They would be, if they were smart, they would attack me or attack my town and just siege it and not take. Oh, here they come! Come on, yep. Attack me, son of a bitch!
That's an interesting army.
Indeed, that only 4 archers. That is really awesome.
Yeah, and it's all Yari.
Yeah,
all of it. With the exception of the generals, of course. If you kill those generals, that'd be fantastic. The Daimyo and the Samonair.
Well, I'm just going to give you a light cav again. Just same tactic, and we shouldn't really take too many losses here. Mm-hmm. The battle meter is, like, directly in the middle as well, which is interesting.
Yeah. Which means this should be easy.
Indeed. Yeah, this is... Was it 6 or 8 gunmen? So this is going to be a piece of cake. because I'll be having guns everywhere. You can just kite them wherever the hell you want, and they're gonna die.
Yeah, just surround the entire thing with guns.
Yeah, exactly.
Although maybe not the back, because the back is just pointless.
Yeah, obviously, but yeah, I know what you mean. Yeah. That's another shame about this game. That, like, I can always sort of say, yeah, the main army is going to come from there, and there's a gun that come from there, and sometimes they do it a little bit differently, but you'll never see them going around, like, that mountain behind, or mountain, that little hill behind, and try and attack from the back or something. You'll never see them do that.
Yeah, they don't tend to use terrain to their advantage unless it's, like, a giant hill.
Yeah,
that's
exactly.
That's the only way they do it.
But that's the most basic thing, like, even I, or, like, that's the first thing we do, is, like, look for the biggest hill we can take.
Yeah.
But besides that, they really don't do it, which is a bit of a
military tactics 101, but when it comes to sieges, they're just like, yeah, just approach from all sides.
Yeah, which I guess that is a pretty normal tactic, but yeah.
It is, but when you've got a raised area that you can just walk up to their walls at, you know, you'd go there.
Yeah,
and
indeed.
They never do.
Alright, I'm going to...
You can actually deploy, like, really far outside the walls.
Holy shit, yeah, you can. Alright, I'm going to put the most experienced one in the middle again, because that's where it seems to be the most useful.
Mm-hmm.
And you guys like that. Oh wow, I actually don't think I have to do that, really. Too many men for that.
Is this a fort or a stronghold? It's a fort, isn't it?
Yeah, it's got no... Fingers,
yeah, no
so.
Towers.
Like that. And I'll do you guys... Oh, shit. Nope, not out there. That. And... You guys... Over yonder. You guys over yonder. You guys over... Hitter or something. Alright. Yeah, that's a pretty decent... Actually, I'm going to split them up slightly.
Don't forget your bowmen in there as well.
Yeah, I'm not going to put them on the wall, though. There's no place for you.
You want them in loose formation behind the wall somewhere, don't you?
Yeah, that's what I did last time as well, and actually got a few kills, but they do die very quickly, because they're not, like, in defense mode, but...
Yeah, but, you know...
It works over there.
Your bowmen dying, then your guys on the wall,
exactly,
so.
Yeah. Main army's probably going to come from there again, by the way.
Yeah, probably.
Let's put the katana... Oh, the katana... Right there. Hopefully they don't get shot. And my generals in loose formation. Sort of like that. And hopefully they won't get shot, and otherwise I'll move them. Right. Let's do this. Oh, wow. That is an interesting... Whoa, I've never... Okay, so they did mix it up a little bit.
Mm.
That works, though. What's that? That is bow, 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 and bow. Yari, 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 yari. All right. Okay, that's awesome. So all four of their bowmen are on the left. So you might actually, I don't know.
Avoid them?
Yeah, but I think, I was thinking, like, it's going to be one of those situations where if you're running around, you might be able to just, like, charge in them while you're dodging, basically.
Possibly. The issue about having all the infantry in the south is that if I try to kite them, they've got three generals down there.
Yeah, that's true.
I don't want to try and kite these guys with the archers, because the archers will just shoot me.
I'll keep my gunmen the same way they are, although they are going to be useless on one side, but I guess that's a side that you can just come to and kite them around.
Yeah, I'll kite people around to a side that's of use.
In that case I'll actually move my generals back a little bit, otherwise they're going to be shot.
Of course, means you know where to put your archers.
Yeah, putting them up forward now. Actually, oh yeah, you mean like on the other side, so I can counter their archers.
Yeah, that's what I would do.
Yeah, although I think actually no, yeah, that's a good thing. I'll move them back slightly, because that might actually mean that their archers are going to move forward to try and shoot them, meaning that they might get into range of my gunmen.
Well, I have four light cav here. If they move their Yari Samurai past their Bow Ashigaru, I could actually take in the horsemen and tried to attack them.
Yeah, that's what I meant, yeah. Do you want another general, like the shittier one?
No, it's alright.
Okay. I wasn't going to give him anyone, I would.
My one concern is if I start trying to kite with these guys and then they send the generals after them. That's my only real concern.
Oh, they're charging you already.
Yeah, that's alright.
Well, you can outrun them, and again, just run them in front of my gunman, and the general will die immediately.
Yeah, I'm wondering which way the general's gonna go. So far zoomed out right here. I can actually see, like, all four of the units on the screen at once. In this camera angle.
Oh yeah, I got it as well. I think I'm using the same as you are now.
Probably. It's really good. Because I can see exactly where the splits are coming. And exactly where I need to be moving the guys out to. Those archers are nearly in range now.
Their entire army is following you. I've got nothing to do now.
Well, their generals were marching straight through the middle. So, it would have been nice.
One general's coming for you, it looks like.
That's alright.
And the other one's coming for the other two units.
Okay, that's fine.
If you can get up the hill there, you might actually... right, so yeah, I'll have some Yari Samurai probably coming up the wall soon. And I've got the Bowman over here.
Oh, they changed their minds.
Aww.
That's fine. Oh, maybe they didn't.
Alright, we're about to start firing the first volley.
Okay, I'm about to swamp their generals. This might end badly, actually. Okay. Well, might lose a few light cav here, but did quite a bit of damage to their generals.
Alright.
Yeah, one's down to 5 men and broke. The other one's down to 5 as well.
I made his Boishigaru come all the way in range of my melee troops as well, so that's good.
Very nice. I broke 2 of his generals there.
Nice.
I only lost like 20 men per unit. Which is pretty good.
Indeed it is.
Well, at least the light cav have gotten their kills for this match.
They're done.
Yeah. Are the Yari Samurai leaving those Boishigaru alone?
Wait, what?
Yeah, they are. I'm gonna smash those bows.
Oh, right, those three over there. Yeah, they're all like this three massive stacks of them, isn't there?
Yeah. Setting different targets for all of them. You've already shattered some Yari Samurai, that's nice.
Yeah. I have to switch around my katana for a mesh lock on the wall though. Need to get these Yari routed and then we should be alright here.
Yeah. Hopefully these Yari Samurai don't intercept me on the way in, because I really want to smash that big blob of bows.
Our general is in grave danger, my lord!
Is he really? Look how much I care. Come on, hit him, hit him!
Oh, nice, yeah, I didn't even see
that.
Look
at that. Isn't that just a beautiful sight?
That is very good, actually. Oh, we're shooting the Yari Samurai that's following you.
Sweet, I'm gonna pull out of there. So I don't want to lose too many horses. Yeah, that did a lot of damage.
What about the...
Took hardly any casualties there, too.
About to shatter his men up the walls here, and then I can put my guns on there again.
Very nice.
Alright, I shattered, so... So are they?
They've made the same mistake again.
Lol.
Yeah, I'm gonna punish them for it.
Well, they didn't. Yeah, it wasn't really a mistake. It was more that they're all dead now. Or at least the ones that were supposed to be defending them. Yeah, I'm about to start shooting them as well, actually, so it'll be good.
I'm gonna up the hill a little bit before I just smash into them right here. Here we go.
I'm meant to stop firing now.
Oh, they're in a giant fucking blob right here.
Oh, look at that, just running through.
They are pretty knackered, so their effectiveness is very, very low, but...
It's alright, keeping them busy again, though.
Yeah.
Alright, start firing again. Everyone should have reloaded, yep.
Yeah, took quite a lot of casualties right there. Have to split them up now.
Have to split them open. You could bring them back inside if you wanted to. I think we're good now, mostly anyway.
Yeah, I'm just trying to avoid for the most part right now.
Yeah, at least get the 12-man one inside.
Our men are running from
the
battlefield. Oh, they
actually just routed. So
shame for this play.
But they should be fine.
Yeah, I don't think I can bring them back because they're shipped.
Nah, they're gone. But there's enough of them left that they should be fine because they're all just fleeing over there.
Yeah, indeed.
I don't think there's going to be enough there to kill them.
Generals are coming up the wall now.
Yeah, their generals are gonna die.
That's my most experienced units right there as well.
That is not going to be pretty,
my lord.
But it is,
some must rest.
Yeah, for us it is.
Yeah.
Oh, there's a Leica running right in front of them.
Yeah, hopefully they don't lose too many men.
Yeah, I'm about to start shooting the Leica now.
Oh yeah, they are losing men here.
Oh shit. Well, it's not the hardest thing to make a Leica unit. Plus, I was actually thinking of losing one anyway. I'm shooting them off the wall, and that's not very pleasant.
No, it's not, is it?
Oh, one of them's running. Oh, and actually, he's confident that he's still running.
Interesting.
My lord, their general has fallen.
Nice.
A cutting
dead general.
Blow.
Oh, some of his gentlemen are falling off as well now. Only 7 men left. I don't know if I want to take these men off the wall. I guess I will.
Just going to.
Oh no, they're already shattered.
Yeah, I'm just kiting all of their Yari Samurai right across the front of the castle now.
My lord! A glorious victory will soon be yours!
Yes, it will.
Indeed. Yep, everyone just shattered.
Yeah, those guns are really nice.
You have no chance against me. Oh, one of my gun units only got one kill.
Really?
Yeah, that's the one that's all the way over here who's not doing anything. Oh, decisive. I was actually expecting a heroic one again there.
Yeah, I'm surprised it wasn't, actually.
Maybe you're not allowed to use any... Sorry, not allowed to lose any units or something?
Maybe.
I don't know if that's like a condition.
I don't know. You should hopefully have some of that unit left.
I think they got... Because they ran right for the general unit, so they just got killed as they went through. So
yeah.
I think it's completely shit done now. Which is fine, because... It's the easiest thing to replace. Like mine, just they didn't have anything special except for maybe a few experienced chevrons. But besides that, like I said, I was thinking of getting rid of one unit anyway, because I wanted to have one general and 3 light cav instead of 2 generals and 4 light cav. Yeah, we lost the unit. That's fine.
Yeah. The annoying thing is if they'd not broken, then I could have gotten them out of their position.
Yeah, because you were about to run them inside as well, but oh well.
Yeah.
Kills 305, 250, 228, 141, and then the light calf of 134. Not bad.
Mm.
Not too shabby.
Not shabby at all.
Oh wow, he got experience for losing. Are you having a laugh? Oh, don't do that. Okay, that only cost me 800, which is alright.
Yeah, it's not too bad.
Yeah. I'm only making 4k a turn now, though, instead of the 6k, but meh. I can
deal with that. Takaoka are offering me peace.
Yeah, I'll do the same after that battle.
Yeah. See, they realize who the real military genius is here.
That's another thing with bad AI. At some point, you'd think that they might consider a different approach to fighting our gunmen rather than running around the castle getting shot in the back constantly.
Nah. Desecration.
He put 5 men here. I can just take them out. Or I can actually follow up on that other unit and take him out. That works too. Oh yeah, 3-star general right there.
Huh. So I can either have minus 25% to the cost of imported gunpowder units and plus 100% town growth for the Namban port for 4 seasons. Or plus 4 happiness and plus 10 town growth in this province for 4 seasons. I think I'm going to go for town growth and happiness.
Sounds like a good deal to me.
Yeah, I thought so. So, I really have nothing to do, I don't think, because my recruitment queue is full. I suppose I could start like moving some of these other troops around that I don't need anymore. Yeah, I don't need any of these troops in Osumi now.
Do you have 100? Well, you, I know you do, but can you spare 165 coin for me?
Oh, I don't know about that.
165. That's like 1/200th of your, probably less than, or more than, less. I don't know how to explain that. It's not a lot, anyway.
Yeah, I can do that. How much did you want?
165.
165. Okay. Here you go.
Look at this idiot Shimazu offering me money for nothing.
Let us speak.
Alright, can make my military port now. Lovely.
Good. Military ports are nice.
Yes, they are.
Oh, lovely. It's just sitting right outside there. Okay, so, yeah, they're happy as well. So I can take all of these Yari out as well. Wow, I've got like 7 units of Yari Ashigaru here. Really don't need them anymore.
I don't need you anymore.
And I don't need one of these guys in Hyuga. Why is Hyuga's... Oh, okay, because it's only 75% Christianity right now. And dishonorable daimyo as well, which sucks. I'm half tempted to disband these Yaris. I really don't need them.
Yeah, I would if I were you.
Or I could send them up and give them to you, but I don't think you really want them, do you?
I can take the one with the experience and the superior armor, but besides that... Yeah. Well, even then, I don't think I use any Yari. I should go, well, to be fair, they're still good against cavalry, but then again, guns are also good against cavalry.
Yeah, well, guns are good against everything.
Yeah, that's true. Okay, except for bulletproof Naginata.
Yeah, that's true.
They exist.
Not that there's going to be many of them.
No, and even if there are some, I reckon even if they have bulletproof armor, they'll still die after a few shots.
Yeah. I'm thinking I'll get rid of these Yari Ashigaru and the bow Ashigaru as well. It's not really a lot of point having one bow unit.
That's true.
Yeah, I'm just going to get rid of all those Ashigaru.
You should use the same army that I have in my single player campaign. Just pure melee. Just charge in there, murder stuff, and get out.
It's warning me that I'm going to lose agents if I disband my Yari. I don't like it when it does that.
Lose agents?
Yeah. Which tends to suggest, like a Matsuki or something. And I do have a Matsuki there. So, yeah, that's kind of a little bit worrying.
Wait, I don't understand. If you disband the Yari, you lose agents?
Yeah, apparently.
How does that work?
I have no idea. But when I selected them individually, it didn't give me the message. So, yeah, screw him.
Okay.
Right, how long till this... 2 turns until the Namban trade ship is done. I can't believe that they've just left my trade fleet just sitting on the trade thing and they cleared off the other one. Doesn't make any sense. What's that?
Yeah, oh. It's a bit odd, isn't it?
Yeah, the Takioka are like between our two trade posts
yeah,
as well.
Yeah, I can see them too, yeah. I first have my own big navy against the Chizukabe here. A big navy fight, I mean.
Where's that?
In, right here.
Oh yeah, I see.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's going to be an interesting one.
Yeah, I do have some spare ships like right next to them though, so I got 11 warships versus his 10
Yeah, it does look to be in your favor.
Yeah, he does have some trade ships as well, badly hurt, so should be alright.
Wow. Yeah, everyone hates us.
They do?
Yeah, yeah.
Good, because I hate them all. Die.
Alright, so that's everything, I think. Yes, that's everything. So it's end turn.
Yeah. Alright, port blockaded. Beppu. Sea trade route raided. Sea trade route raided three times again. Safeguard. The people in this province are encouraged by the substantial garrison stationed here. Plus 50% wealth generated by buildings in their province. Iwami. Alright, thanks.
It's always nice when they give you free stuff.
Yeah, I'll have it. Construction report. Made some basic buildings. Good. Alright, let's take these two ships. No, actually, let's take the medium Bune. Shove them in there. And then we'll put these guys on the edge. And then we're gonna attack you. Alright, you're gonna flee. That works too. Ooh, that is okay.
That was a very effective fleeing they just did.
Yeah, this battle meter is surprisingly not in my favor. All they have is Boku Boy has and a bunch of trade ships, whereas I have medium buoys with a ton of experience, and still it's only barely in my favor. I mean, auto's over regardless though.
Yeah.
Lost three ships, gained five. Oh, lost four ships actually, still fine. I just care about them going away. And I guess I gained some experience for some ships as well, so that's alright.
As long as they go away, that's my only deal.
Indeed. Is this navy full? Yes, it is. Do you have some spare cash?
Actually, I do.
No, it's fine. I don't need it.
Okay.
I don't need your money.
I have plenty of spare cash.
Yeah, that's true, but it's alright. There's no rush. Alright, my European cannons are actually in Nagato now, so they're getting there. I'm gonna take my missionary. Let's have a quick look over here, see if their army is still in Aki.
You might want to just put it slightly inside their territory to make them unhappy.
I could do that too. Yeah, because I don't need him in Iwami, do I?
No, not really.
I guess I'll, yeah, since he's here, I'll just try and demoralize him again. Yep.
Have you looked at his name?
Adalberto Ferreira. That's him. Right.
Ridiculous.
There. It's probably Italian.
Oh yeah.
Most likely. Right, yeah, I think I should be able to move far enough to actually get rid of this army here. Not gonna be able to flee anyway, so get away. Some more experience, good. Die.
They're all dead.
In town. There you go. Lovely.
Very nice.
Right, so I'm out one unit. Like I said, though, once those European cannons get there, I might get rid of one of my generals, like the Sun and Air, and start making a new unit or a new thing for him. And then just
You'll need a general to have your new army led by.
Yeah, exactly. So that's what he will be for.
Oh, there's so much experience on those matchlocks.
Holy shit, yeah, there is. That is not bad. But they're still way worse than the Portuguese Tercos that I still not able to make yet. Well, I am able to make them, but money.
Yeah.
Right. Let's see. Is there anything else? Because I think we need to end it here anyway.
Yeah. Well, you could always take money from me and build them for me.
Yeah, that works.
Because I kind of want some for my army as well, so.
Yeah, do you want me to do that now?
Yeah, why not?
Do you want some Dunderbuss cavalry as well?
Nah, I'll just stick with the matchlocks.
Do you want some European cannons, fire projecting mongonals, or Yari? Yeah. Do you want some Yari Yashigaru?
Oh, well, they're tempting.
I figured, yeah.
But I think I'll pass on the rest of them.
Oh my god, I got the thing that improves the firebomb for accuracy, plus I've got Fletchers in here. So, the firebomb accuracy is 90.
Fucking hell.
Holy shit. That's pretty sweet. Anyway, right, so it's 893 per Portuguese Tercos.
Okay, and how long do they take to build, and how many can you build?
I think I can make three a turn.
Okay. What, three actually per turn, or three every two turns?
Three every two turns, I reckon.
Okay. Well, if I have six of them, then, that'll take, what, four turns?
Yeah.
Okay, how much that'll be?
5,400 and minus a little bit, but
Alright, well, it's your turn, so you have to demand money from me.
That is a good point.
Yeah.
Shimazu. Payment,
this
demands.
This is a good day. A friendly visit. Good conversation. And perhaps a profitable outcome for
apparently
all.
My prosperity is only moderate. Suck my balls, my prosperity is moderate.
Mine was affluent.
Yeah, you apparently were richer than I was.
Right, yeah, it's I had a spare 42 coin, but I assume that's not. That's interest for making those units.
Oh, the
cheek.
The cheek of it. Oh, made me speechless by your arrogance.
How dare I?
Yeah, how dare you.
Right, so let's end it here then.
Yep.
Right, so it was my intro, so I shall end it. What happened today? I'm not even going to talk about Ptolemy because. What has he done, really?
There's nothing to talk about.
No. So I lost Aki to the Chescabe, which I'll probably be fighting a lot in the future. But I defended Iwami successfully, or we defended Iwami successfully. Barely lost anyone, except for some light calf, but what are you going to do? So the Takaoko are out one massive army. And hopefully the Chescabe decide to attack Iwami so I can defend it again and then take it back from them and then get rid of them all together on this island. Besides that, I've been making tons of buildings, but that's probably what Ptolemy has been doing as well.
Yep.
So, yeah, that's it. Goodbye.
See ya.